Oh, so this is going to be the messy episode, I see. Well, I'm here for it. Let's get into it. So now we're back in the workroom and all of the queens are like really shook because I think that this is the first time that they've realized that the power of elimination is in the hands of the person who wins the lip sync for your legacy. Like, it's no more of, I think I have an idea of who's going home. It's like, now we know that whoever has the power, now they finally have figured it out, that whoever has this power makes this decision. So now they're all kind of nervous and a little bit shook. And I'm like, Trixie, you better start working on some alliances. So now we have the Snatch game. And if you watch my previous reviews, you know that this is my favorite challenge. Because for me, I personally get to see which queen has a career outside of just drag, you know what I mean? Who was more of a crossover queen that can actually book acting jobs and, you know, get on a TV show, get a film gig, or be able to actually hold a show? Because you can, I'm not saying it's very easy to lip sync to a song, you know what I mean? There is work to put on a show, but there is so much work going into learning lines, learning blocking, learning your lighting, learning how to embody a character and also stay true to the character, but also get the reaction that you need and are hired to get from the audience. So that's a lot of work. So I like to see who I should be looking for when the show wraps. And that's why I really like the Snatch game, because I'm able to see the queens outside of just, you know, lip syncing in a fabulous gown. I'm actually able to see who got the chops. So immediately, I'm worried for Trixie. Here is why. I've never seen anybody do a good RuPaul impersonation. And I am also afraid because I've never seen Trixie do anything outside of Trixie. Remember, on her season, she didn't live long on that season. She was able to grow outside of her season. But for those who only know Trixie from just this show and have not been following her since she, you know, was off of her season, I think it was season 5, we really don't know what she's capable of. So I'm actually really nervous for her, because not only are you doing a RuPaul impersonation, you're doing a RuPaul impersonation as someone who is not black. So you have to be careful with how you interpret RuPaul. And also, you're doing RuPaul in front of RuPaul. Sis, I'd be nervous. Okay, so now let's talk about Trixie and Shangela's kerfuffle. I didn't like it, right? This is a TV show, so I do enjoy when the queens are like shady at times, you know, giving a cute little read in their confessionals. I don't like when it gets serious to the point where I feel like relationships are going to be tainted outside of this show, because it really is a small community and I'm just like, y'all need each other. So y'all can't really be beefing. So I didn't like it. It made me feel uneasy, especially when Trixie will leave up such a nasty note. Like, I get that her friend is Thorgy, right? Keep the note, right? Keep your friend's note. Why put it up there when it's saying something really nasty about somebody who's not only doing well, but still in a competition? I just didn't think it was a smart move. Yes, it was your station, but your station is open. You know what I mean? And I don't think that Shangela had a reason to be over there. I kind of feel like maybe somebody from a production told her about it so she can go over there and discover it and have like this real good, like juicy TV moment. And I mean, we got what we got. I didn't like it. I feel like Trixie was wrong for leaving up that nasty note. I didn't like, you know, her and Shangela really getting into something that was serious. You know what I mean? I told you, I'm good for a little read. I'm good for a little bit of shade. But when it gets serious and like really, really nasty, I can't really stomach it. And I just did not like that scene. And also, Thorgy is so pressed. Thorgy is very negative. I know all three of the Thorgy fans had a problem with me saying, you know, that she needs to like buckle up and really get in this competition and not be such a crybaby and such a brat. I meant what I said. Thorgy is too damn big and too damn grown to be such a brat about a drag competition. Yes, money is on the line, but honey, every time you were on the screen on this TV show, you are getting full-on promotion. You're getting a commercial that you did not pay for. Make every second count. And Thorgy makes all of her seconds about hating on a drag queen that she thinks is better than her, than enhancing her own performance. Like, she's so bitter, and her bitterness is going to kill her in this community. She's not going to be able to do anything outside of it. So for me, I was looking out like, girl, you need to get it together, because you're killing your chances on this show. Nobody wants to work with a bitter queen. Focus on your Party City fashions and not on Bob, who was slaying. Now the room is divided and awkward, and nobody is really talking to each other and kikiing with each other like they used to, because of this like nasty moment between Trixie and Shangela. And also, I don't know if you were bothered by it, but the way Trixie told Shangela to get out of her station, for me, that didn't read well, because I just felt like for you to have been someone who offended someone, I don't think you should have taken the position of being like extremely defensive. Like, how could you not think that she would be offended by that note? You know what I mean? And it wasn't even like a genuine, oh my goodness, oh, I was putting on my friend. Like, you know, so that was the thing. I couldn't really ride with Trixie because it wasn't just shock. You know, like, she knew the note was nasty and she knew that it was saying something negative about Shangela. She didn't care that Shangela was offended by it. So I don't know. It was just like, is there something going on with your heart? Are you not understanding why she would be upset? It just was really, it read really, really weird to me. And the energy that that whole little disagreement left in the room was just, it was ugly. It was ugly. And I'm glad, however, that later in the episode, the queens were able to get past it. But, you know, that moment, I was just like, ooh, fast forward.
So, BB,
I've never seen her season. I told y'all, I couldn't do that filter. I tried. I was two episodes in and I was like, I'm done, right? So I don't know if she can actually do characters. I do think that BB has been very safe in this competition, and I think she chooses things that are very safe for her to do. So I'm kind of concerned, but then I'm not so concerned because I feel like she's very smart and she's going to pick something that she can do. So I feel like BB would be able to pull from Grace Jones and really embody that character, because truth be told, I feel like BB is kind of Grace Jones in some sort of way. And I disagree with Aja. Grace Jones is hilarious. Maybe it's her age and she really doesn't like know a lot, but if you know about Grace Jones, you know that not only is she a powerful, like fierce, you know, entity, you know what I mean? She's also very comedic. Hello, Boomerang. I feel like if BB pulls from Boomerang, she'll be good. Good. I'm so glad Rue talked Shangela out of doing that Miss Cleo mess, because that leprechaun in a hood accent that she was giving off was the worst. As soon as she transformed into Jennifer Lewis for just a second, I could see it. I think that was such a smart decision to just switch it up and go with something that you're strong in. Pull a BB. Do something that you know you can do and you can do it well. Oh, I think that Kennedy is gonna kill Phaedra Parks, because Kennedy already reminds me of Phaedra in some forms, because Phaedra doesn't, like, the thing that I think that Kennedy is gonna be able to do well that Phaedra does is that Phaedra doesn't voice a lot of words. She has a lot of sounds. You know what I mean? So it's like, you know what I mean? So I feel like Kennedy already does that. So I don't think that Phaedra will be a stretch for her either. Now let's get into the snatch game. Trixie. Trixie definitely studied Rue. She just could not embody her. It just wasn't good. It was very Rue on like coke. It was weird. It was like a cracked out RuPaul. She didn't get it. She didn't get it. And it wasn't for lack of trying though. I'll give it to her. Homegirl studied her. She just wasn't able to embody her. And it was a really poor performance. However, she has some good jokes. They just weren't able to land because of her delivery. But the writing was there. Ben, I have said it every episode and I'm going to say it again. Ben is poised to win this competition. His Paul Lynn character was hysterical. First of all, you were laughing just at the character alone, because Ben had the jokes, Ben had the mannerisms. Like, if you don't know who Paul Lynn is, you don't need to, because the character is so good. And if you do know who Paul Lynn is, like I do, you are falling out laughing because it was such a good impersonation. Like, Ben was so on point with this. And a lot of people were just like, oh, it's not essentially drag. It's the snatch game. You're playing a character. And Ben came to win and Ben nailed it. And I am so proud. Chi Chi, it's time for her to go. It really, really is. Like, the Maya Angelou, Chi Chi is just not ready for All Stars. She's not. Like, unlike Aja, Aja had one season and came back to kill it. Chi Chi just needs more time. Not everybody is able to do a come up as easily as others. So it's her time to go. If she does not go, I'll be disappointed, because I think that everybody else is really bringing it. And I don't think that Chi Chi is bringing it enough to stay here. And also, it's really unfortunate that she's struggling in this area of comedy, because she's naturally funny. Chi Chi in her reads and her confessionals, just Chi Chi just talking is hysterical. It's so hard for me to understand why she just can't script her comedy that she does naturally. Oh, so glad that Shangela went with Jennifer Lewis, because she is killing it. She has her mannerisms. She has her voice down pat. The wig, like everything that she was doing with this Jennifer Lewis impersonation was on point. Okay, so like Ben De La Creme, Aja is playing a character that you have to know who this character is. not just to get it,
but also just to understand what she's doing. You know what I mean? Because the character on itself seems like just an amplified Aja. But if you know who Crystal LaBeija is, then you know that Aja is killing it. Because at some point, Aja peaks out. You know what I mean? I didn't feel like she was fully committed to Crystal LaBeija, but she studied. She studied and she got her down pat, and I was so impressed.
From the hair to the nails to the point to the mannerisms, Aja did her homework.
She did her homework. And although I don't think she's going to win this competition, I think that she did enough to make herself even more bookable. I think that Aja is going to leave this show with a higher booking fee, not just because she's on All Stars, but also because she proved her booking worth. She's going to be asking for some coins, and they are well deserved. BB, thank you for finally showing up for me. I don't know about your legendariness, right? So this whole competition, I just wasn't seeing anything, but baby, you killed Grace Jones. I told y'all, all she had to do was pull from Boomerang and she got it. Like her first joke to Rue, and all throughout, she was so good.
Trixie keeps on popping in with this RuPaul impersonation. And I know that she's doing it because she wants to at least stay relevant within this challenge, right? She can't sit there and be quiet, even though she probably knows that her Rue impersonation is just not hitting. It's so uncomfortable though. It's such a cringe-worthy performance to watch because you can tell that Rue is not feeling it. Rue is not feeling this impersonation, and poor Trixie, because she can't shut down, because then that will be used against her. So she has to keep going with her jokes. She has to keep going with, you know, the impersonation of it all. But Rue is not feeling it, and it is very uncomfortable to watch.
You know what? I also want to talk about how I feel like Trixie's fans are her downfall on this show. Particularly this competition, right? Because unlike Aja, who even the fans put homegirl through the ringer, what she did was she took those critiques, even the harsh ones, even the hate, and she applied it to her drag and came back so much stronger. Trixie did not do well on her season, right? She kind of faded. And then she gets off of her season and gets all of these fans who are just, who love her unconditionally. And I think that is amazing, right? But I think they love her to a fault. You know what I mean? Because listen, I'm a part of the Bayhive, right? I am a Bay stan. But Beyonce can't do nothing crazy and think that I'm just gonna fall in line. None of the Bayhive is like that. We protect Beyonce at all costs. But when mother is slipping, we let her know with love. And I don't think that Trixie has that with her fans, because even Shangela called it out. She pointed, she was just like, I blame y'all. Y'all were the ones who told her that this RuPaul impersonation was it. Because Trixie was so confident about this RuPaul impersonation. She was saying that everybody loved it. And I feel like it was a Milk and Celine moment, because when Milk was talking up that Celine impersonation, I was just like, oh baby, I don't know how you gonna pull this off. And she didn't, right? And I feel like that's the same thing that happened with poor Trixie. People saw the RuPaul impersonation. It was just like, it's great. People, I mean her fans, you know what I mean? Listen, protect your faves at all costs. Love your faves unconditionally, but also check your faves when they need checking. And y'all should have checked Trixie with that RuPaul impersonation, because now y'all got her on here looking a damn fool. It's your own fault, Trixie Hive. It's your own damn fault. This is why I love Shangela, right? She just has a bright spirit, but I also love how on this show, she keeps on calling out Ben. She was like, oh baby, game, recognize game. She sees what the game that Ben is playing, and she sees exactly what Ben is doing with the, oh, woe is me. I don't want to make these decisions. Oh, I keep on winning. Shangela sees right through it, and that is one of the reasons why I love her, because she calls it out.
Woo! Rue in this runway look, it's a no from me. It's a hot mess. First of all, the dress just looks so DIY. You know what I mean? Like, it's very community theater, Little Shop of Horrors like outfit. It just doesn't look well made. It's poorly fitting on Rue. It just does not work. And the wig is just not blocked out. I don't know what happened this week. I don't know if there was a rush. Something is just really, really off about this whole look. Because if Rue is not slaying a dress, at least the wig and makeup is on point. But this whole look, absolutely not, sis.
So the theme of this week's runway is flower power, and I'm disappointed in it. Not the looks, but the fact that we are speeding through the looks. I had to pause my television so many times because, I mean, the queens only got about 2 good seconds. I don't even think they let them get down a runway. They stopped like in the middle of the runway and then they went to another queen. I hate when they do this in editing because a few times they don't really tell the story properly. So some things are left really long and then a lot of other things are cut short. And a lot of times it's very important things. Like, we tune in for the runway. We tune in for the fabulous looks. Like, y'all could have cut somewhere and gave us longer looks. It was just disappointing. I hate it when they do this. Aja, I loved her look. It was very well put together, from the hair to the makeup, just the whole overall outfit, even down to the shoes. Mother did that. I was very, very pleased with that look. Shangela, queen after my own heart. This Beyonce-inspired pregnancy photo look, gorgeous. So, Kennedy, I enjoyed the look. I didn't like it that much and I didn't really love it, but it was enjoyable to watch. Here's why. I liked how she took the details from the dress and applied it to her makeup. I thought that was very creative. I also like how there was like this trail of flowers engulfing her. I thought it was very creative. The problem that I've always had with Kennedy is that she has these great ideas, very poor execution. It just looked very craft, Sunday school, DIY. It just did not look well put together. I felt the same way about Rue's look, so you know what I mean? But I thought it was creative. Like, she has great ideas, just poor execution. Chi Chi, loved her look, wished it was a gown, because when she made it into a skirt, it just looked really cheap. And I think that's Chi Chi's problem. Like, Kennedy has an execution problem. Kennedy just has a cheap look problem. All of her looks just look cheap, and I don't think that it's impossible. You know what I mean? I don't think that she has to have a bunch of money and all of these things. I think she can really make her looks look well, but I don't think that she has that eye yet. I think what Chi Chi needs to do is to get around more drag mothers. She really needs to get around more seasoned, older drag queens who have been in this business for a while, who are at the top of their game, who are performing. They don't even have to be like Drag Race All-Stars level, right? They could be local queens who have been doing this for years and have been slaying and have like a show that has a dedicated fan base. Get around those kind of queens. Start making more drag queen friends so you can start borrowing gowns. Because, honey, that's the game. A lot of these queens are borrowing gowns, okay? All you got to do is just shout out a queen who lets you borrow the gown or post it on your Instagram or something like that. That's what a lot of them do. And I think that's something that she needs to do if she's always going to feel a certain way financially, not being able to really match up to the fabulousness of the other queen's gowns. I think that's something that she really needs to work on. But even if she doesn't have it, I also think she needs to start training her eye. She really needs to get into some fashion books. Honey, you gotta study Vogue, okay? If you can't afford the magazines, Vogue has a freaking YouTube channel. You can watch the runway shows. Like, you have to get into fashion, because that's the problem with Chi Chi. Not having money is one thing. Not having the eye to be able to see the gowns, to be able to see the fashion transformed, is a bigger issue. Rixie had me gagging. I loved her look from head to toe. Gorgeous. And then Ben walks out. I'm telling y'all, I feel like I'm gonna leave this show being a Ben de la Crimp stan. Ben is just killing it for me. I'm in awe every episode of Ben. Every episode. Like, Shangela, I expected it, but Ben, I'm like, yo, you are going above and beyond, and I am so here for it. Now let's get into the judging panel. Ben and Shangela again are the tops this week. Who's surprised? Not I. I said before, something is off about this episode. The editing is really, really weird. The runways were cut short, and the critiques are like out of order and out of whack. It's feeling very rushed and rugged, and I feel like something is missing from the episode, and they're like trying to cover with these other weird edits. This show was really, really off. Something happened behind the scenes, and I don't know if it was like drama or maybe it was just poor camera work. I don't know, but this episode just seemed really, really off to me. Trixie, Kennedy, and Chi Chi are at the bottom, rightfully so. But I think that Kennedy is safe because, if anything, Chi Chi and Trixie just had the worst performances. And I totally understand Trixie being like, you know, I froze up. I had a very important performance, and I just got scared and I got in my head. It happens. That happened to me not too long ago. I think like last week, actually, I had a huge performance with some juggernauts in the improv community, and I froze. Like, I was very intimidated by the talent that I was working with. I still felt like a student learning from the master, in a sense, and I bombed. But I was able to get it, bring it back, you know what I mean, and get it together. But it was very humbling and embarrassing, and I felt defeated. So I totally get where Trixie is coming from. A lot of times when you're a performer, there are just certain performances just that just get you, you know what I mean? You get in your head, you get really scared and intimidated by it, and you can't perform when you're not free, because performing is very freeing. When you're not free, when you're still holding on to like chains of fear and just doubt, you can't give your best performance because you're not there, you're not in it. And I think that's what was going on with Trixie. She was intimidated by the RuPaul impersonation, and she never really got any critiques. So when it came time for her to perform, she just got in her own way. And I totally get what she's saying, and I totally understand. And I don't really have anything like negative to say. I don't have anything negative to say about it. I'm not gonna beat her down because I know what that's like. I really, really, really do. But the good thing about it is, if you're good at what you do, you get back up again and you kill it the next time. That's what performing is about. That's what we do in this community, this performing community. Sometimes we scrape our knees, another time we win Oscars and, you know, accolades. It is what it is. We keep on going because it's what we do. So brush your shoulders off, Trixie, and get back up there, girl. You got it. So all the bottom queens, except for Chi-Chi, is trying to stay, really, you know, pleading their case with Shangela and Ben. And Chi-Chi is just like, do the right thing. Like, Chi-Chi's ready to go. Let her go. Please let Chi-Chi go. Because at this point, I'm just kind of disappointed. You know what I mean? You have a great opportunity, and it's not admirable when you throw it away, because you're essentially taking the space of somebody who really wanted to be here. If you didn't feel like you could compete when Milk's name was called, honey, you should have been like, you know what? I'd rather go over Milk. I don't want to be here. I don't think I should be here. But Milk deserves this. Milk wants to be here. That's what I felt like Chi-Chi should have done. To stay another week and just not give it your all, and then be in the bottom and just be like, oh, you know, I didn't do well. It is what it is. Like, it's not commendable. It's actually sad and upsetting, and it kind of pisses me off, because if you're not going to fight for it, then you should have fought for another queen to stay here who really wanted to be here. Now we get to the lip sync for your legacy, and I honestly feel like nobody wants to win, because if either one of them like sends home Trixie, which I don't think they will, I mean, like, the obvious choice is absolutely Chi-Chi, but you never know, right? So if they send home Trixie, you don't want to deal with that fan base. Like, nobody wants to be in that position. So I'm kind of feeling like this is probably going to be a throwaway for the both of them. But I think Ben is really going to try to throw it away, because I don't think that Ben wants to be that queen. You know what I mean? Like, Ben is playing a smart game. A very, very smart game. Okay, well, I take everything that I just said back, because as I'm watching this lip sync, let me tell you something. Shangela and Ben is playing a win. Like, they want this $10,000. They are going after it. And if Trixie gotta go, then Trixie gotta go. Cause these queens are singing the house down, and I am here for it. This is what I like. Like, play to win. And actually, they both end up winning, which I think is a very smart decision that Rue made, because honestly, I couldn't see myself making that decision to pick between one of them. They really did a good job. So I like the fact that they won. I also like the fact that they both got a chance to choose who to send home. And I was nervous because, you know, Trixie and Shangela had that issue in the beginning. And I was like, is Shangela going to be petty, or is Shangela going to be smart? And Shangela was actually smart. She sent home Chi-Chi. I was like, smart, smart girl, don't play nasty. Because the thing about it is, these girls got to get booked after this show. And nobody wants to be that nasty queen. No shade to Fifi, but word on the street is, honey can't get hired in any club. But also, it was her presence off of the show as well, because she was really nasty on Instagram and on Twitter. And then went on a whole tirade against RuPaul. So I was just like, honey, you sank your own ship. Ben also picks Chi-Chi, which wasn't a surprise to me, because Chi-Chi was essentially telling Ben to send her home. So bye, Chi-Chi. Girl, I was rooting for you. We were all rooting for you. But just like Tiffany on America's Next Top Model, you ain't want to be here. So you were over the competition at some point. Chi-Chi, this is the thing. And I'm speaking as someone who has been through this, sometimes still deals with it, but the older I get, the more I'm able to tackle that demon for what it is and overcome it. When Chi-Chi is faced with something difficult, she bows out. She does not rise to the occasion, and she does not show up enough, because there have been times where she showed up, but it's always been in challenges where she was comfortable, or in moments where she was just having a good time. And that is not life, and that also does not work in this competition. And I feel bad because I watched somebody essentially do something that I did when I was much younger. Like in high school and college, that was my thing. Whenever something got difficult, I just would not rise to the occasion. And I watched so many people who were less than talented than I become great. You know, get parts, get positions that I knew that I should have possessed, but I threw it away because it was difficult. But that person wasn't bothered by the difficulty. They went after it, and whether they failed or not, they kept on going. And I think that's something that Chi-Chi just has to learn. You gotta keep going, honey. Even when it's difficult, even when you don't think that you can do it, you gotta shut that voice down and you have to go after it. And it's just really unfortunate. I feel like that Chi-Chi could have really showed us what she was made of, because Aja did. And not to compare her, but let's be real. Aja didn't have a great season, and her season was last season, but Mother came back and she killed. She showed us what she was made of. She might not win this competition, but she is going to get paid. And that's all I wanted for you, Chi-Chi. I didn't think you were going to win this competition, right? But I wanted you to leave being bookable. And at this point, I don't think you are, because you keep on shooting yourself in the foot. Anyway, that's where it ends. Next week looks really messy, and I'm actually going to watch it and review it. I'm sorry that this is a little late. As I said before, a girl is booked and busy. It's pilot season out here. If you don't know what pilot season is basically where all of the TV shows that you see throughout the year, or the future TV shows that you will see throughout the year later in the fall, are casting for actors. And I'm an actor, you know, so I'm going on a lot of auditions. I'm in a lot of shows. I just filmed a pilot. I just did a huge performance at DreamWorks, which I can't really talk about, but when I can talk about it, I'll let you guys know everything. So it's just really, really busy for me, but I love you guys and I love doing this, and I just have a good time. And thank you so much for checking in on me and just, you know, wondering where I'm at and, you know, wanting to discuss the show. I appreciate it. I really, really do. You're not bothering me. Thank you for loving what I do and thinking that that this is important enough to want to check up on me and see, you know, what's going on with the kid. I appreciate it. So stay tuned, because I am going to do this week's episode. So if you like what you see here, please like, comment, subscribe, and share. And I will see you for the following episode of RuPaul's Drag Race, coming up in a second. Just you wait. It should be suggested like somewhere right here. I'm sorry. I'm trying not to show my nails because they are jagged. I haven't even had any time to go to the nail salon, y'all. Pray my strength. I'm out here looking a mess, but I'm booked and busy. God is good.